Hey everyone, and welcome to my channel, Health Info Expert. Today, we're going to talk about sleep drive and your body clock. Once again, this is a topic that I'm really passionate about, because sleep is so important for our overall health and well-being. Why is sleep drive important? Because it helps you fall asleep and stay asleep naturally. Without sleep drive, you would have to consciously force yourself to sleep, which would be pretty much impossible. Sleep drive helps you to get enough sleep, which is essential for your overall health and well-being. When we don't get enough sleep, we can experience a number of negative consequences, including fatigue, difficulty to stay concentrated, and getting irritated easily. Sleep deprivation can also increase our risk of developing chronic health conditions such as heart disease, stroke, obesity, and diabetes. If you have any of these conditions that already troubled you long enough, you really should finish the entire video if you want to know why you don't usually have good sleep drive, and most importantly, how we can help you improve your sleep drive and make your life a lot easier. So, what exactly is sleep drive? Sleep drive is the body's natural need for sleep. It's what makes us feel tired at the end of the day and ready to go to bed. Sleep drive is regulated by our circadian clock, which is a 24-hour cycle that controls many of our body's primary functions. It's controlled by a small group of cells in your brain called the suprachiasmatic nucleus, SCN. The SCN is sensitive to light and will respond by suppressing melatonin production. So when we're exposed to bright light during the day, it helps to keep our circadian clock on track. However, if we're exposed to bright light at night, it can disrupt our circadian clock and make it harder to fall asleep. Some of you may want to know, why don't I have good sleep drive? There are a number of reasons why you might not have sleep drive, including poor sleep hygiene. This includes things like going to bed and waking up at different times each day, napping during the day, and using electronic devices in bed. Your circadian clock is heavily disrupted. This can happen if you're exposed to bright light at night, or if you have a job or lifestyle that requires you to work irregular hours. Getting older, as we age, our internal sleep clock starts to lose track of time. Older adults tend to get tired earlier and wake up earlier, and they sleep less overall. The risks of cognitive decline or memory problems are also increased. Medical conditions and medications. Some medical conditions can indeed interfere with sleep drive, such as depression, anxiety, chronic pain, sleep apnea, restless leg syndrome, etc. Some drugs like corticosteroids and antidepressants can also make people suffer with sleep. If you're struggling with sleep drive, there are a few things you can do. 1. Go to bed earlier and wake up at the same time each day, even on weekends. This will help to regulate your circadian clock and make it easier to fall asleep and stay asleep. 2. If you're exposed to bright light at night, try to dim the lights in your home and office in the evening. Make sure your bedroom is dark, quiet, and cool. Darkness promotes the production of melatonin. This can help you sleep better. 3. You should also avoid using electronic devices in the hour before bed, as the blue light emitted from these devices can disrupt sleep. 4. Definitely avoid caffeine, and ideally, alcohol too, before bed. 5. Regular exercise can help to improve sleep quality, but try not to exercise too close to bedtime. 6. Create a relaxing bedtime routine. This could include taking a warm bath, reading a book, or listening to calming music. 7. If you're concerned that you might have a medical condition or medication that is affecting your sleep, make sure to talk to your doctor. How to reset your sleep schedule if it is already disrupted? You can reset it by following these steps. 1. Choose your new desired wake-up time and stick to it, even on weekends. 2. Go to bed 15 minutes earlier each night. 3. If you can't fall asleep within 20 minutes, get out of bed and do something relaxing until you feel tired. 4. Repeat steps 2 and 3 until you're able to fall asleep and wake up at your new desired wake-up time without an alarm. That's all for today. What else do you want to know more about sleep drive and your body clock? Don't forget to like and subscribe for more great tips to get yourself healthier. Leave a comment if you happen to find something useful for your life in this video, as this really means a lot to me. Thanks for watching, and until next time, stay healthy, happy, and sleep like a baby.